Think of a technology breakthrough that led to a major boom and bust cycle. The dot-com era, perhaps? Or cryptocurrencies? We're thinking of a very different example, actually one from much further back. Trains. For the modern mind, it's a bit unnatural to imagine trains as much of a breakthrough. This is a Victorian-era technology, after all. But consider that before trains, traveling or moving goods any substantial distance by land was slow and dangerous. While primitive, horse-powered rail systems called wagonways were used in the UK from the 17th century. The 19th century brought us the steam-powered locomotive, and that changed everything. Suddenly, a week-long carriage journey became a day-long ride. Faraway resources were now within reach. Dozens of new rail businesses were quickly formed, and investment poured in. Time itself was changed. Well, timekeeping. The need for uniform rail timetables led to the first ever standardized and widely used time zone, railway time. But just decades after the first railways opened in the UK in the 1820s, things went bust. Projects had been mismanaged, and the supply of tracks had been overbuilt for the early demand. The UK's so-called railway mania of the 1840s was then repeated across the Atlantic. Subsequent boom and bust cycles soon rippled through the US over the next few decades. And while the rail industries in both Europe and North America suffered a similar fate, their journeys differed in a key way. In North America, the boom was driven largely by freight demand, shipping resources back from the western frontier. In Europe, the boom was largely driven by passenger demand, people traveling between cities. And this legacy continues. Today, rail in North America is roughly 80% freight. In Europe, it's 80% passenger. The passenger and freight sectors have a lot in common. The industry fundamentals are fairly similar. In many places, freight and passenger trains share the same tracks, in fact. Of course, there are some key differences. Different customers and different underlying economics. Hint: freight rail is purely commercial and makes a healthy profit, whereas passenger rail is often a far less profitable public good, supported by government funds. In this primer, we'll cover the ins and outs of the rail industry, passenger and freight, short distance and long. We'll discuss the players in the ecosystem, the different models used in different countries, the various steps of the value chain, the economics of the companies that operate trains, the manufacturing of the trains themselves, called the rolling stock, and the key trends to expect.